Purdue, who's running for governor in the state of Georgia, tells Stacey Abrams that she needs to go back where she came from. Here's the video.
Hey, she ain't from here. Let her go back where she came from. She doesn't like it here. The only thing she wants is to be president of the United States. She doesn't care about the people of Georgia. That's clear. Hey, she ain't from here. Let her go back where she came from. She doesn't like it here. The only thing she wants is to be president of the United States. She doesn't care about the people of Georgia. That's clear.
Stacey Abrams, African-American female, running for governor. Now, remember, the primary election is today. Republican primary, Democratic primary. Purdue may not even advance in the Republican primary. But he's taking shots directly at Stacey Abrams. Now, he has a problem with black women in particular. If you remember during the campaign trail, he said this about then candidate for VP, Kamala Harris.
And Kamala, I don't know. Whatever. And Kamala, I don't know. Whatever.
Okay. It's disrespectful. And it's red meat for his base. He knows exactly what he's doing. Even the trope that he made about go back to where you came from, and everybody started smiling and applauding. He understands what he's doing. He's not saying you need to go to the state you were born in, which would be Madison, Wisconsin. And the reason why, and I know people will push back and say, oh, Doc, he was talking about the state she was born in. Let me tell you why that's not true. Purdue has never referred to any of his white opponents in that way. Out of his white opponents, 80% of them were not born in the state of Georgia. Have you ever heard him say they need to go back to where they came from? Get my point? All right, Adrienne, thoughts here.
No, you're absolutely right. And this is also part of the game that we often see when white people engage in this racist rhetoric is saying, oh, no, that's not what I meant. You took it wrong. Or, oh, it was just a joke. It was just in jest. It's part of this white supremacy kind of push, this thought that, oh, it's not as you see it. And same kind of thing when we look at what the KKK and the fact that they wear hoods, because it's this thought of a ghost. You didn't really see it.
Yeah.
And so when we have these implications of racism and here with the massage noir targeting this black woman in particular, what we're seeing is racism, sexism play out in form. And the fact also that what Donald Trump dropped Purdue, it's kind of like he's truly showing his real colors and he is not going to win. But what he will definitely be is labeled a racist as far as I'm concerned.
Well, yeah, and his actions definitely are racist. And let me say this, because he was posed a question that almost every Republican has to be asked now. When you lose, will you accept the outcome of the election? Here's how he answered that question.
That's why that poll was full of crap.
Yes, sir.
Are you going to accept the results of this election?
Well, it depends on if they're fraud or not.
And how are you going to tell if there's fraud or not?
Because Dominion is here.
The question is,
well, if it's fraud or not, that's it, right? Nothing else. So this has now become the new thing with Republicans. They are not going to accept defeat. They are not going to accept the outcome of an election, even though they tell you to vote because the election is actually secure. That's what they will say. Vote for me, your vote will count. But then they lose, they will say, you know, really didn't count because it was all rigged and there was a conspiracy against me. Okay, Adrienne, final thoughts on this one.
Yeah, definitely. It's a sense of entitlement. This thought that, no, I deserve this spot. This spot is mine. I don't even have to earn it. And thus, in the event that it's not given to me, I know it could not have been fair because I am entitled to it. And it's in that same vein of telling her to go back to where you're from. It's this sentiment that this is my land. I am entitled to this. I have a right to this. And we know that history definitely doesn't support that in any way. But just this entitlement, it is dangerous, it is scary, and it is anti-democracy.
It is, and it's pro-white privilege. And here's the other dynamic. You know, we're supposed to live in a country where people pick the politician. We're now starting to de-evolve into a country where the politician picks the people, they pick the voters. And they are seizing power in a dictatorship fashion. This is the beginning of a dictatorship network that we have to fight against vigorously.